Here I've got a block on a spring, and I've compressed that spring 30 centimeters below its equilibrium length. The spring has a constant of 350 newtons per meter, and then we're going to release the system, and the spring uncoils and shoots the mass upward. The mass flies up into the air to some maximum height, and that's actually the first thing that I want to compute because it's actually the simplest. And then I also want to compute, well, how fast was the block going right at this moment where it was released from the spring? So I put in some dashed lines here as vertical reference lines. And you need to define what's the origin going to be for your y coordinate. And typically it's easiest to make it the lowest point in the problem. So I'm going to make y equals 0 right there. And then up here, that means that's at y equals 0.3 meters or 30 centimeters. And then up here, y is equal to the maximum height, and that's actually what I'm trying to solve. So let's look at going from this initial state. That'll be the initial state for both problems. And then this will be the final state for my first question, which is, what is the maximum height? Now, we do get some zeros in here. If I look at E initial equals E final, energy is conserved. In my initial state, I've got no motion. That means no kinetic energy. 1/2 mv² has got to be zero. There's also no gravitational potential energy because the y coordinate is equal to zero there just because we put our origin in that spot. So as long as you're carefully reasoning through each of these types of energy, spring potential energy, kinetic energy, gravitational potential energy, if some of them are zero, you don't have to write them, but just make sure you actually think about whether or not they're zero before you proceed. So all I have is spring potential energy. In the final state, my spring is uncoiled, so there's no energy there. I do have gravitational potential energy, and then I'm at my maximum height, which means V is zero, so there's no kinetic energy. So the only survivor here is my gravitational potential energy. Again, this is fine to write it down this way, as long as you're arguing with yourself about why the terms that vanished should vanish. Well, then I can solve for y final. I've got kx initial squared over 2mg, and I'm going to plug in my numbers, 350 for the spring constant. Converting to SI units, my 30 centimeter compression is 0.3 meters, and I've got to square that. Over 2 times the mass, again, I need SI units, so 0.5 kilograms. G is 9.8. And when I run the numbers, I get 3.21. Yeah, 3.21. meters. So it's probably good to remind you that the trade-off with energy methods is that I don't know anything about the details that are happening in between the initial and final state. It was really complex. I had the block accelerating at some rate until it shot off of the spring, and then it was in a vertical free fall problem, slowing down until it got to that maximum height. And I don't know any of those details. All I have is the answer to my very specific question, how high did it go? All right, let's look at finding the speed right at the end of the decompression of the spring. This is a more complicated question. So I'm going to call this my final state. And forget about the first one. And if I plug in what's going on in the initial state, well, that's just as simple as it was the first time around. All my energy was spring potential energy. I set my y coordinate to zero there, so I have no gravitational potential energy. But then in my final state, I have some gravitational potential energy, so that's going to be a mgy final. And I have kinetic energy. I'll just use a v for that. You could use a v final if you like. So I'm trying to solve for V final here. And I guess if I stay symbolic for the moment, I'm going to multiply both sides by 2, and I get kx initial squared. This term becomes a 2mgy, and I'm going to subtract it. So minus 2mgy final equals mv squared. Then I'll go ahead and divide by m and square root the whole thing. So V is going to be the square root kx initial squared minus 2mg y final over m. So it's so important on this particular one to not accidentally neglect the gravitational potential energy. This block is higher than it used to be. So there was an increase in gravitational potential energy. Some of the spring potential goes into that, and the rest goes into the kinetic system. Let's plug in our numbers and get a numerical answer. That's 350 for the spring constant. X initial for the compression is 0.3. Square that. Minus 2 times the mass, which is 0.5 in SI units. 9.8 for the acceleration of gravity. Y final here, 30 centimeters higher than when I started. So 0.3. All divided by the mass, which was 0.5 kilograms. And when I ran the numbers on this, I got 7.56 meters per second.